We all have read books, we have seen videos, or we have attended workshops which talk about secrets of happiness to us. We all know the secrets of happiness, but do we really know the secrets of unhappiness? Today I want to talk about the secrets of unhappiness. And because these secrets are known to all of us, I am calling it as open secrets of unhappiness. Because it's open, you know, everybody knows it, but still they indulge in it to become unhappy. So what are the open secrets of unhappiness? Today let's take a look at one of the open secrets of unhappiness, and that is social comparisons. We compare ourselves with others all the time. It's kind of inevitable for us to compare ourselves with others. But it's one thing to compare ourselves with others to feel inspired by it. You know, we look at somebody who is a good singer and feel like, you know, I want to be singing like that, I want to achieve like that. They become role models for us. These kind of comparisons are not bad. Or we look at somebody who is a good player, you know, who is a good sports person, and feel like, you know, I want to be a sports person like this. These kind of comparisons never really make us feel sad. What makes us really feel sad is comparing ourselves with others in areas where we kind of feel I should have what they have, you know. And what are these areas? One of the first things we often compare ourselves with others is in physical appearances. You know, we look at somebody who is more handsome, who is more beautiful, who's got different features than us, and feel like, you know, miserable that they have it and I don't have it. This is one of the major areas which really makes us feel miserable. Another major area is, of course, educational achievements. We look at somebody who is better qualified than us educationally and feel like, oh, I did not have this. No, I wish I had had this. And we actually don't do anything about it. We just feel miserable about it. We don't really take action to kind of say that I want to achieve that. That is inspiration, you know, what I talked about earlier. Here we are just comparing ourselves just to make us feel miserable, right? And the third area where we compare ourselves is with fame, you know, of a person. This person is more popular. Why is he or she more popular than me? And we feel terribly envious of them, or terribly jealous of them, and we feel miserable about it. It doesn't really make us happy. These kind of comparisons never really make us feel happy, right? And then success of others, you know, whether it's success in relationship, whether it's success in terms of work, we look at their success and feel I should have had that success. And last but not the least, of course, is financial comparisons. You know, we look at somebody who's got more material success than us, you know, he's richer than me, or he's got a bigger house, a bigger car, and I feel, oh my God, I should have had this, right? And this is very easy to measure. The financial is always easy to measure, and it can be easy to compare and feel miserable about it, right? So these are the main areas where we normally compare ourselves with others and feel miserable. When we do the comparison, we never really compare ourselves with people who are out of our league. Whom do we normally compare ourselves with? We compare with our siblings, we compare with our cousins, we compare with our classmates, or we compare with our colleagues and feel they have it, I don't have it. My brother has got a bigger house, my cousin has got a bigger car, my classmates, you know, they have had better education than what I have had, and we really feel miserable about that, right? If I'm comparing my wealth or my financial status with somebody else, I'm not going to be comparing with Jeff Bezos, Warren Buffett, or Mukesh Ambani and feeling bad about it, right? I'll compare myself with my cousin, right? My cousin or my brother or my classmates, and feel like, you know, they all had greater financial success, but I have not had it. So why do we do this comparison? Why do we really compare ourselves with others? First thing, we feel like we are equals. You know, I and my brother are equal, so I should be having what he has. Right, that sense of equality comes in. That's the reason, one of the reasons why we compare. Another reason is that, you know, we feel like both of us have made the same effort, although it may not be true, right? Both of us have made the same effort, but I have not been rewarded, which leads to the sense of, you know, injustice. You know, the life has been very unfair kind of comparisons. Or we compare ourselves with others because we feel like both of us had the same beginning, right? We all started in the same level, but he has gone ahead and I have not gone ahead. That illusion that we all had the same beginning comes in. Or of course, forget all the four of them, we just feel like I should have had better than what he has. I don't even want to give a reason. That's a sense of entitlement. No, I should have had. Why I should have had? No reason. I don't even want to give a reason for that, right? So when this kind of comparison happens, we really feel miserable about it. It's one of the open secrets of unhappiness, right? You never really feel happy when you compare your life to somebody else's life in any of these areas. You don't really feel at the end of the day, oh, I am better off. You always feel like I'm worse off than others. You know, that sense of misery always comes in. So how do we stop this? You know, because it really doesn't help. Social comparison doesn't really help. So how do we stop this? If we want to stop this, there are two things that we need to look at. Right? One is a better understanding of what's happening around us. And third is practicing awareness. When we talk of better understanding, what do I mean by better understanding? What should we understand better? The first thing we need to understand better is that our lives are different, right? My brother, my cousin, my classmates, they are not us. Their life journey has been different. The paths that they have taken have been different, right? When we understand that, when we understand this point that, you know, our lives cannot be compared with somebody else's life because their life has been different or their journey has been different. We understand that we did not have the same starting line. No, we did not begin at the same starting line. We may think that, you know, what's the difference between me and my brother? We all had the same house, we all had the same parenting, we all had the same environment. So we all had the same starting line. Or we compare ourselves with our classmates. You know, he and I were in the same class, and today look at where he is and look at where I am. Just because you were in the same class doesn't mean that you had the same starting line in life. You know, your friend may have had a better parenting, your friend's parents may have had better resources at their disposal. They may have had better network of people around them which helped your friend to become whatever he is. So just because you were in the same class or in the same house does not make that you had the same starting line. When you understand this second point, it leads to a understanding of the third point, and that is the very small differences in the beginning over a period of time can lead to a large difference in the outcomes. Let me give you an example. Suppose I compare myself with my brother and I feel like, you know, look at where he is and look at where I am. My brother had and I had the same parenting, we lived in the same house, we shared the same resources. But let's say that my brother had a friend who was staying abroad, and he pulled my brother to let us say America or some country like that. And from there my brother flourished, you know, because he had a different opportunity, he had a different risk taking abilities, and he has really become something really big in that country. And today if I look at it, where did we start? We started in the same house with the same parenting with the same resources, but the small difference that he had a friend who helped him out made a large difference over a period of 30 years, right? It began with a small difference, but that small difference, it added and added and added, and incrementally we look at 30 years later that his life is totally different from mine. So if we want to stop social comparisons, we have to understand these three points: that our life is not the same as somebody else's life, our starting points are not the same, and the small initial difference in the beginning can lead to a very large difference in the outcome at the end of 20 years or 30 years. The second point we need to bring in if you want to stop social comparison is practicing awareness. When do I do this? No, I focus on my thinking. When do I socially compare? Do I do it every day? Or do I do it whenever I meet this person and come back? Right? Do I do that? So I should become aware of my thinking and then bring it to the level where I stop it. No, I say, no, the thoughts have started now. No, and my thoughts have started of social comparison. I don't want this story to go on. I'm going to put a stop to the story of social comparison. Right? At that moment, you become aware and you put a stop to it. Or you just take that story to the logical end very fast. You know, we actually know where the story ends every time, right? We always know where the story ends. That's always a loop thinking. So I can just take the story to the end and stop it at that point itself. Right? So if I can practice that, if I can bring in a better understanding and if I can practice awareness of my thinking, we can put an end to the social comparison part of it. There's nothing wrong in desiring a better life. There's nothing wrong in wanting to have, you know, better education, better material prosperity. Absolutely nothing wrong with it. But you know what the mantra should be? The mantra should be, I want what I want because I want it, not because somebody else has it. Right? When we start looking at somebody else has it and I want it, the social comparison starts off, and that leads to just miserableness for all of us, right? We will be in utter misery when we socially compare ourselves. This is one of the easiest paths where we can get rid of one of the unhappinesses in our life. Can we practice that?